to another season of PTV. I'm Erin Johnson.
And I'm Sophie M. We're excited to get our 10th season of Panther Television underway.
In fact, we were so excited that we couldn't wait until the new school year began. So we took our cameras to the Phillips County Fair held in late July to show how area students were involved. Take a look.
4-H'ers in the area were excited as the Phillips County Fair kicked off on July 29th.
My favorite day of fair is definitely the day we show our beef. It's always been one of my favorite things to do. It's a long process to build to that day, and it's just really relieving to have it done and see the results.
Although many of us associate fair with livestock, the event actually began inside with consultation judging.
I got champion on my quilt for the inside projects. I also did pictures, sewing, and baking, and arts and crafts.
Kids of all ages got in on the fun, with FFA participating too.
So this year at fair, FFA did the grease pig contest. We did it last year. It's really a good time. Lots of kids come out. They have an awesome time with it. This year we had 5 pigs, and we had 3 divisions, and we had a really good time. They drug them around, and like I said, it's good for the kids to get some energy out before the beef show.
4-H'ers take great pride in all their accomplishments.
My favorite part of fair is spending time with friends and animals. I brought 2 heifers. My black Angus did the best in her class. She got champion in showmanship.
Some local high school 4-H members even double up their duties.
So when you get in high school, you can do 4-H and FFA. So with FFA this year, we had a team consisting of me, Erin Johnson, and Maddie Johnson. And we got 3rd as a team.
And this is a really great opportunity for kids because it helps them learn their public speaking skills, and as well as they can kind of make decisions about animals and explain why they did that. And these are real life things that they'll have to carry on in the future.
For PTV, this is Erin Johnson.
Not only were students involved in activities like 4-H and the county fair, students were also involved in events like the farmers market.
The Phillips County Farmers Market is a new attraction that is held on the second Tuesday of each month in the summer and early fall. Watch this to find out more.
A new way of buying local goods and products has come to Phillipsburg.
Phillips County Farmers Market is a place for consumers to connect to where their food comes from in a local source, creating support for that short food supply chain and supporting the small businesses that are here and bringing community together.
This is a great opportunity for somebody who has a small business to be able to come out and have a crowd to see their product.
I think just getting the word out, a lot of people that don't know that I do this kind of stuff, even people that I've known for years that don't know that I do this kind of arts and crafts or t-shirts or anything like that, they know that I can offer this to them.
Phillipsburg High School students are getting involved too.
We are selling baked goods to earn a little bit of profit before the school year starts. It helps us promote SCCLA, and it helps us promote all the clubs in Phillipsburg High School, and it helps us really promote our motto and what we do.
We think it was a great idea for FCCLA to be a part of this. FCCLA, FFA, some of those groups and activities are career technical education clubs at our school or organizations at our schools, and those are students that we are training to be the future entrepreneurs of America.
People enjoyed the opportunity to gather together as a community.
My favorite part is definitely seeing all the community here and seeing everyone I know just walk by.
Seeing everyone come out and support a local event, support local talent, support local food growers, everything like that, just seeing the community event gather.
Both interacting with customers, I am a vendor myself, but also seeing the community come together and support one another is wonderful.
For PTV, this is Sophie M.
He's a 10, but he plays emo music on steroids and weights.
I'm gonna have to give that one a 4. Yeah.
She's a 10, but she's addicted to Diet Coke.
I'm gonna have to go with a 6.3. He's a 10, but he stays hydrated all day, but for every sip, he has a jingled eye.
More like a 7, but tips for being hydrated.
As the new school year begins, wait, I'm getting a message, so we need to interrupt our regular broadcast for a special announcement. Let's send it out to Carson Meidel for a special report.
Hello everyone, I'm Carson Meidel. I am outside of Phillipsburg High School right now where our STUCO president is pulling up.
Thank you. Stop. Thank you, Phillipsburg High, for joining on this PSA, this public special announcement. I would like to inform you that our homecoming theme for the dance is going to be Hawaiian Hoko. We are excited to have a great year. Thank you.
Thanks for that update. Now, as the school year begins, there are several activities. Hold on, I can't believe this. We have another special report. Let's go to Carson for more.
Hello, people. This is Carson Meidel outside of Phillipsburg High School, where our FFA president is pulling up.
Settle down. Hi, my name's Leighton Johnson of the Phillipsburg FFA chapter, and I'm your president. This year in FFA, we hit an all-time high in membership. We have 850,000 members enrolled. That is an all-nation high, and we want to see that number keep increasing. Some upcoming events is Dairy Cattle Judging and Green Hand Conference. Today, we had our membership drive. We're so excited to see what this year will be. As always, keep America great.
Sophie, are you waiting for something? Go ahead and introduce the next story.
I was just waiting for the next special report to interrupt our show, but I guess I can go on. As the school year begins, yep, I knew it. Another special report.
Okay, here we go. This is Carson Meidel reporting live where the KAY president is pulling up.
I'm McKenna Russum, and I'm your K's president. Thank you for coming to the club fair. It was a big success. And just remember that your membership fee is $20. Our membership drive is September 16th, so remember to bring those dues by then. We will have ripper floats, so it's very vital that you come to get those. And we look forward to a great year. Thank you.
I'm not sure where Sophie went. Maybe she had enough of all the interruptions. I guess I'll introduce our next story. As the new school year begins, students can join new. Oh my, looks like we have another special report. Okay, let's send it out to Carson one more time.
Hello folks, this is Carson Meidel reporting from outside of Phillipsburg High School, where the FCCLA president is pulling up.
Thank you. Thanks, Buster. Got it from here.
I'm Sophie M., your FCCLA president, and we have many exciting things planned for this school year. At every home football game, there will be our booth selling caramel apples. Make sure you come out and support. They're really good. We also, on September 13th, are hosting the Stand for the Silent presentation. And on the very next day, September 14th, we're hosting the Color Run for Suicide Awareness. Make sure you stay tuned for all of the other fun activities FCCLA is doing this year. If you still want to join, you can get a form from Mrs. Weisar. Thank you.
I
I think that's the last of the updates.
Looks like we saved the best for last on those updates.
If you say so.
Stuco, FFA, CASE, and FCCLA are only some of the great organizations we have at PHS. There are a lot of activities to choose from.
To get to know more about what all of these activities have to offer, PHS held an activities fair. Here's more on that.
To get more students involved, the PHS clubs and organizations held this year's activity fair.
Today, students are coming down to the auxiliary gym to find out about all the clubs and organizations that they could belong to as a student of PHS. They're finding out what the clubs are all about. They're finding out what the fees are to join the clubs, and they're finding out what they need to do to become a member.
This event is especially important for freshmen and new students.
I've learned a lot about what the different activities are about and what the different clubs do, and I've had a lot of fun, and I've already signed up for two.
It can get people involved in clubs and stuff to help them get into the community more.
For PTV, this is Hiram Miner.
He's a 10, but he doesn't want to have snow days off.
I'd give him a 3. She's a 10, but she gets mad at us for looking at people on the freeway.
I'd give that a 4. He's a 10, but doesn't know how to laugh.
I'd give that a 6. He's a 3, but he jingles his keys in the hallway.
I'd give that a 5.
If I can fit it all in one sack, $1.
Some cute little colorful socks going on. Okay. I don't know if they'll let you wear this, but we got you a little hat. Here's the shirt. School colors and all.
Oh, cute.
Yes, yes. Perfect size.
Yeah.
To go over your gray shirt, got a little summery jacket. The little flip-flops and flowers. Don't you love it? Look at the little girl at the beach.
Looks so cute.
And tie it all together. Got you some shoes.
Those are humongous.
I think they'll fit. There's some nice solid ones. And of course, got a little handbag to carry along with you. You know, pencils and such. Pencils. Now for the accessories. So I got you a nice little lace bracelet. Let's see if it fits. Hopefully it does.
Yep.
Perfect fit. We got you the purple earrings.
Cute.
And my favorite, a Peppa necklace. You know, peppers.
I see that.
Done.
I think we'll go with these.
outfits. Okay. So, first, you're gonna need some underwear. So I got you these.
All right.
Solid. And then, for your pants, got you these cool things.
We love some high waters.
I thought they were cute. And then, this is your undershirt. Oh, it even has padding on this.
Oh,
yeah.
We got some shoulder pads going on.
And then,
I was going to get you that. I was literally going to grab you that.
And then this shirt over it.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, I got you some really cool shoes.
I bet they won't.
You're good.
They won't fit.
Oh, and then I just thought to spice it up, you a tie.
Sure.
It's pretty cute. Oh, you need some socks for your shoes.
With the heels, of course, they match.
And then we got some cute earrings. A cute bracelet.
Oh.
And one more thing. A cute necklace.
Oh my god.
Those are quite the outfits.
Yeah, they're decently sly. It's fun to see what you can find at the thrift store. When we were filming for that challenge, everything we could put in a paper sack was only $1.
What a bargain. With prices like that, groups like the Amendment wouldn't have to do fundraisers.
I don't think Mrs. Pinkerton wants the Amendment dressed in random thrift store clothes for our concerts.
You're probably right. In our next story, you'll see how the Amendment is not only raising money, but also spreading school spirit. Take a look.
To raise money and promote school spirit, the Amendment is painting the town blue and gold.
It's a fundraiser. It raises money for new uniforms and tour that we're going on and just other fun things that we do.
It's a fundraiser for Amendment, but also it just really generates a lot of Panther pride around town, and so that's why we decided to do it again.
The Amendment is preparing for a fully packed year of singing and other fun activities.
We have a ton of things planned this year. One of the new things we're going to do is we have a trivia night coming up next month where teams can sign up a group of up to 5 people for $50. That trivia night is here at the high school if you want more information. We're also doing our usual fundraisers like singing Valentine's. We're doing our benefit in the spring. We have our concert at Christmas time, as well as MCL this fall. And also after the school year ends, we have this year is the tour. And so we'll be returning to Branson to open for 2 shows there.
For PTV, this is Nathan Fisher.
Now it's time for the fit check. First thing I got you.
Isn't this against the dress code?
Guess we'll find out. Okay. Second thing I got you. We're gonna go with the shoes next. I think those might be your size.
Yeah, they're about right.
Perfect. Are they big enough or are they...
Yeah, them work.
Perfect. That makes me feel a whole lot better. I'm going to save that for last. The next part of the outfit. You know? Are you going to need a belt?
Yeah.
Perfect. That'll just make the outfit look way better.
There's no tag.
Now, the part I was the most excited about. I'm a proud dad of a fucking awesome nurse.
Oh my god.
I know you're gonna look the best out of anybody here. What'd you get me?
Let's pick out an outfit.
From you might not like that. Thunder and check.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Overshirt.
Okay, well at least it'll cover the back part of it. Ooh, fancy. Are these? Okay, maybe this might not be the worst.
yeah, wait for this.
I wasn't that mean to you.
Good guys. In fact, I'd say you're ready for Picture Day.
PHS Picture Day was recently held, and Luke Hoover gives us the inside look.
We're good to go. Thank you.
To start the school year off, PHS held the annual Picture Day for all students.
Just taking school pictures for IDs and yearbooks. Today, I woke up at 5 o'clock, left the hotel by 5:45, got here by 6:45 to start by 7:45. We get here, we set up our entire portable studio. And go from there.
Having a successful picture day relies on help from organizations like the K Club.
Today's picture day. KAY runs the picture day every single year. So the school director, which is Callie Leidig, kind of organizes it and helps them mostly. But as president, I'm just here to help her out. Picture day is kind of just like a timeline for parents to look at from kindergarten to senior year and see how much their kid has grown up.
In a photograph, we made these memories for ourselves.
Although all students get their picture taken, pictures for seniors take on a whole new meaning.
Currently I am getting my senior photos taken by the wonderful and amazing Amy Epley. I think that they really capture the essence of your entire senior year, kind of, because you can change things up and put in different things and just show who you think that you are during that year, and then you can look back on it when you're older.
Senior pictures also have a meaning for the photographers as well.
Seniors just, it's kind of their moment to shine. You know, during family photos, you get your single photos taken, and at school you get them taken, but seniors, it's all about you. We kind of go where you want, if you have something specific you want. It's kind of a fashion show for the girls. I don't think boys really care too much, except you'll get the odd one that wants his car or a sport, but it's just the time where it gets to be just about them and they get to kind of show off their personality.
For PTV, this is Luke Hoover.
He's a 10, but he uses a red laser to point at the words on his board.
7.
She's a 10, but she greets everybody by saying, "Hi, friends."
She's a 4. He's a 10, but he works with his brother.
3.
She's a 10, but she gets paid to wait for our...
No, she's not on the hex zero.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got one. She's a 10, but she doesn't bring me her delicious cookies to sample often enough.
You must be talking about Trinity Gross, and her cookies are definitely a 10.
Watch this next segment to see how she uses her sweet talents to make some extra dough.
For one PHS senior, what started out as just helping her mom in the kitchen has turned into creating her own sweet business.
It really picked up last year during probably about this time I decided to like bake cookies, but I've always been helping my mom bake cookies since I was little. I started selling cookies like through Facebook, and in probably 2 days I could make a little over $400, but it just kind of depends.
Although Trinity's baking business includes making cakes and other tasty treats, her favorite item to make has always been
definitely cookies. There's just so many flavors and just a bunch of different unique ways you can make them.
Passing on the baking tradition has been a rewarding experience.
Oh, she's done a fantastic job. I'm really proud of her. It's really exciting to see her learn and grow fast.
For PTV, this is Hallie Jerby.
Now it's time for our PTV sports update.
Hey Panther fans, it's time for your PTV sports update. I'm Luke Hoover.
And I'm Carson Meidel. Fall sports have just begun and our PH athletes are hitting their stride.
That's especially true for our cross-country team who began competition this week. PTV's James Crashar caught up with the team to get a preview of their season. Take a look.
For the Panther cross-country team, getting the season started meant putting in the extra work before practices even started.
The kids really did a good job in the off season. We ran either 3 to 4 times a week over the summer as team runs, and a lot of the runs they were encouraged to do on their own time, and a lot of them did do runs on their own time. And we had some runners get anywhere between 100 miles to 200 miles over the summer, and so several of the kids did a real nice job of getting ready, and I think they're going to find out that that's going to pay off this fall.
Speed, but it's not just like all out speed.
Young runners will gain a lot of experience on this year's team.
This year's team, we have 9 total runners, 4 girls and 5 boys, and we're a very young team. We don't have any seniors on the team. We have 1 junior, which is Adam Mascarenas, and then the rest are all freshmen and sophomores.
PHS runners are setting goals and looking forward to getting started.
My goals for the season are mainly improving on my times last year and just trying to help the team get better.
This season I'm looking forward to meeting all the new people and improving my time.
For PTV, this is James Krausar.
The cross-country team will compete in Stockton on Thursday for the next meet. Good luck to all of our runners.
Our tennis team returns some key players from last year's season, including senior McKenna Russum, who competed at state last year. The team is off to a good start as they won their opening round robin tournament in Waukini last week. Then they had success again as they played at home earlier this week. Audrey Bellis brings us a closer look at how that went.
The PHS girls tennis season is in full swing as the Phillipsburg hosted a round robin earlier this week. Highlighting the day was number 1 singles player McKenna Russum, who went 2-1 and placed 2nd.
So far I think I've done really well. My first tournament in Trigo I got first. I beat a girl that I played at regionals who beat me by a lot, and so it was really good to come back and beat her. And then I played Hayden Bellamy for the championship, and last year I lost to her 4-8, so it was good to get another game with her. I hope to definitely beat her at some point this season.
Number 1 doubles Jaden Bellis and Jocelyn Billings had a strong day, going 3-1 and finishing in 2nd place.
Today went pretty good. We started off with a pretty challenging match. We ended up going into a tiebreaker on that one. We lost it. Our second one, we whizzed through pretty nicely. Our third one, we were losing 3-6, I want to say. And we came back and ended up winning that 8-7 after tiebreaker. Then our last one flew by pretty nicely. To end the day, I think we ended up placing 2nd.
Number 2 singles player Olivia Soliday also had a nice tournament as she won all 3 of her matches and placed 1st. Number 2 doubles Emma Dibble and Cameron Bruning finished in 3rd place after winning 2 of their 4 matches. Coach Jarvis is pleased with the progress her team is making.
We've had a really good start to our season. We've been at one tournament at Kini, and our team placed first there for the varsity, and today we had a very close second at a big 16 tournament here. We were second to Colby by only 2 points. Our girls are all improving and playing better. McKenna had a really great match today against the girl that got fourth in state last year and took her to 5-8. Lost, but played really good and pushed her. So our singles are performing well. Olivia got first today at number 2 singles. And our doubles, it's just, we're just starting to learn how each other plays and improving. Every tournament we play, they're improving. So I'm pleased about that.
Players are looking forward to a great season.
My goals are, of course, make it to state, but to play my hardest and just get better at each tournament and make it through regionals, pass the first round better than last year.
This year, I hope to go back to state and maybe go further and possibly place there.
My goals for this tennis season is to see how nice I can make my knee brace tan line, but also, more importantly, to get to regionals and make it to state.
For PTV, this is Audrey Bellis.
Our tennis team is back in action tomorrow at Colby for a tournament. Good luck to the tennis team.
Our volleyball team enters the season ranked number 9 in Class 3A as they return several starters from last year's squad, including senior standout Heather Skemper. The Lady Panthers started their season at home with a triangular on Tuesday. Here's how those games went.
The Lady Panthers opened the season at home on Tuesday when they hosted the Trigo Lady Eagles. In the first set of the match, Phillipsburg took control early as two inside set up outside hitter Heather Skemper for this kill. Skemper continued to be a threat at the net as she had 15 kills for the match. Two insides was another Panther scoring threat as she tallied 5 aces for the match. The Lady Panthers maintained momentum and won in 2 sets, 25-15 and 25-11. The second match of the night for Phillipsburg was Plainville. Phillipsburg jumped to an early lead as they continued to be strong at the net. To finish off the night, not only did Sophia Riffle get the match point kill against Trigo, but she does it again against Plainville as the Lady Panthers win 25-12 and 25-10. Coach Rickham was pleased with their team's performance.
Well, tonight I think we came out and we had a good overall team win. We played a lot of girls, we tried a lot of new positions, so I think everybody kind of got a chance to get on the floor and see what they could do. So I think overall it was a good team wins.
The players also thought tonight was a good start to this season.
Well, we started off pretty well. We had a lot of good passes. We didn't serve as well in the first game, but we picked it up after that. We had a lot of good serves, and we just put down the ball really well and took care of it. I think that the team did really well at communicating and like being enthusiastic and just playing to our level.
One particular play seemed to spark the team the most.
In the first game against Trigo, it was the second to last point, and we had a really good hustle play, and Taryn had a great set, and it was just overall really good, and I put the ball down.
The team is hopeful that the season will continue to be a big success.
My goals for this team are to be MCL champs and hopefully make it to state. I'm looking forward to postseason and just seeing how well we do as a team, and because we have really good chemistry together, and just seeing how well we do and what we can do together.
For PTV, this is Adam Mascarenhas.
The volleyball team stays busy next week with the Triangular in Stockton on Tuesday and a duel with Minden at Minden, Nebraska. Good luck to our volleyball team.
So Carson, you pumped for tonight?
Do you even have to ask? We play Smith Center in our first game of the season. Of course I'm pumped.
I'm excited too. To get a preview of this year's season, Damian Gregory met up with Coach Fiskus and his team. Take a look.
The Panther football team is geared up and ready to get the new season started.
This year we have 46 individuals out for football. We got 5 seniors and we got a lot of underclassmen. not the biggest group size-wise, but we got a lot of fight, a lot of tenacity, guys that want to get after it, want to play hard.
Senior Jesse Blackburn has high expectations for his team.
Our goals this season are same as any other team, make it to state. That's the final goal.
To attain those goals, Coach Fiskus has made a few changes.
We got a few different things. Our practice routine's a little bit different, especially at the beginning. Then we got a couple new plays that we put in. But as far as that, you know, it's kind of basic Panther football that we've had for the last several years.
But there's one thing that always remains the same, and that's the excitement for...
home game Friday nights. Doesn't get any better than that, getting to play in front of your home crowd.
For PTV, this is Damien Gregory.
We hope to see everyone fill the stands at Smith Center tonight to cheer on the Panthers. But if you can't make it, Luke here will be doing the streaming duties for PTV, so tune in on YouTube to watch.
That's all the time we have for sports. I'm Luke Hoover.
And I'm Carson Meidel. As always, go Panthers.
Before we show our last thrift store challenge segment, we'd like to thank the United Methodist women who run the thrift shop. We appreciate them allowing us to film in their store. In case you're in search for some great bargains, the thrift store is open on Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays.
Now, here's the last segment of the thrift store challenge.
I think I want to put her in that.
It's giving zebra print 2011, but it's giving if Regina George was a grandma. Okay. Then I got you this amazing necklace. I mean, it is just so cute. Like, look at that. Like, that's killer. And then these shoes are so cute. These shoes are just, I've never seen anything cuter. I am gonna look like a grandma. If Regina George was a grandma, though. No, but I'm not blonde.
I don't know what to get her.
They probably won't fit.
Okay.
And then I got this little 80s shirt.
Uh-huh. It's something my dad would have worn.
Yeah, it's cute. Okay. And then I got you this like leprechaun necklace.
Wait.
I should have got you sunglasses. Okay. And then okay, sorry, don't complain. When you don't really have a cute outfit. And I got you these shoes. Okay. Well, yeah, that's it.
Oh, I was about to say you got me more?
No. That's it.
That's it.
That wraps up our first episode of the new school year. I'm Sophie M.
And I'm Erin Johnson.
Stay classy, Phillipsburg High. I say right foot creep, ooh, walking with that heel. Look around, stay low. Black top, big t-shirt, Billy. Watch on my wrist, but I want that diamond. I really like Cole. What do you like about Cole? It's cold. A good little bit nuts. It has the juice. What you got?
Alrighty, see ya.
Top 10 reasons why Diet Pepsi is better than Diet Coke.
Fake news. Yeah, we fancy like Applebee's on a date night. Got that Bourbon Street steak with the Oreo shake and some whipped cream on the top two. Two straws, one check. No, ain't nothing gonna